The Howard Stern Show.
When you were doing Batman Forever, and you were making that, the legend goes that you were on the set fighting with this guy, Tommy Lee Jones, all the time. That the two of you did not get along at all. That you annoyed him,
well,
he annoyed you.
Well, I think what happened was, you know, I was really looking forward to working with Tommy because he's a fantastic actor. And he still is to me. I love him. I mean, he's amazing.
Right.
But he was a little crusty. He was a little crusty, and you know, he's sometimes that Rhodes scholarship is a more of a weapon than an asset, and I think he was just a little freaked out because Dumb and Dumber came out on the same weekend as Cobb.
Right.
And Cobb was his big swing for the fences.
Right.
And
it didn't work out.
That didn't work out, and that freaked him out a bit, I think, and it made him I walked into a restaurant about, you know, the night before our big scene in the Riddler's lair, and the maitre d' said, "You're working with Tommy Lee Jones, aren't you?" I said, "Yeah, I am." And he said, "He's in the back corner. He's having dinner." I said, "Oh, great. I'll go say hi." And I went up to say hi, and the blood drained from his face in such a way that I realized that I had become the face of his pain, you know, or something. And he got up kind of shaking and hugged me and said, "I hate you. I really don't like you."
Oh my.
Wow.
And I was like, "Wow, okay. Well, what's going on, man?" Like that. And he said, "I cannot sanction your buffoonery."
Wow.
Yeah.
So he didn't want to work with you at all.
He did not want to work me at that point. And I said, "Well, you know, I think this part requires that the tone of this thing is like kind of childlike evil and stuff, and I think you might be having trouble getting there." You know, so I wish you the best, but, you know.
Wow.
What a strange thing, you know?
Yeah, I mean, it was a hard one. That was a hard one.
Yeah.
To go to work the next day was pretty tough.
Because you don't generally find that, right? I mean, people seem to like you.
Oh, yeah,
you're a good guy to work with.
Yeah.
You haven't had any kind of animosity directed towards
you. Yeah, sometimes they think I take too many takes, but I don't give a damn because all that matters is what ends up on the movie.
Why is that a bad thing to take too many takes?
It's not a bad thing.
Right. I would think that it makes the movie better the more shots you get.
If you feel you don't have it, you got to do it until you got it.
Right.
That's all.
So, in other words,
I will bleed from the throat.
But the lesson we learn is, I always assume with a guy like you, with your kind of specific talent, that you, like, things come easily to you. I would imagine you on the set of a movie, you kind of nail it and they move on.
Mm.
But it's not that case. You have to work hard at this.
Well, I work hard beforehand. I mean, like, the first Dumb and Dumber, you know, the Farrellys and me sat down for like 3 weeks beforehand and went through the entire script and make sure that it's everything. There's moments in every scene that are really outlandish.
And people assume that because it's a comedy, they don't think there's a lot of hard work going into it. It's 10 times harder than doing a dramatic
role,
isn't it?
It's like the Dick Van Dyke Show, the old Dick Van Dyke Show. I'm up just going back and forth in the room and going, "What about this? What about this? What about this?" And I'm a spewer. I need someone else to sit in front of the computer, and I just spew. And sometimes it's just absolutely asinine and doesn't fit at all and ruins the plot and whatever. I just, whatever's in my mind comes out, you know, because you never know.
The Howard Stern Show.